The Westlake Hornets have had very interesting national championship luck these past few seasons. Let's start all the way back in Season 6 in the very infamous game against the Penn State Nittany Lions.
Wanted to kick a 48-yard field goal. It's up, and it is no good. It's short. The onside kick. If Westlake gets it, it's game over, and it's doubled, and Penn State recovers. Oh, my word. Westlake bobbled it, and the Penn State, their last time out, they're going to go for the touchdown now, which is certainly risky, as Britton, incomplete. It's actually going to be a real fumble. Underwood picks it up to eventually end the game quicker as McCarty on the option. McCarty keeps it. Now he tosses it for Pettit. Pettit will take it the distance for a Penn State touchdown play. McCarty looking to throw it under pressure over to Wilson, and he gets it. First and goal for one. Britton hands it off for Ellis. He gets the touchdown. If Westlake does not convert, then Mason Conway will always be surrounded by the fact that he made the wrong decision. And did he get in? They say no! Champ Britton scrambled, and it looked like the Penn State player got him.
The Hornets did not make it back until Season 10, but in years 10 and 11, the Hornets got that championship glory.
Back in, number 13 on the left side of your screen. Curtis looking for Wiggins. That's a touchdown! Tying the school record for most passing touchdowns in a season, Wiggins has already long broken the school record. Is in the game, by the way, on the Hail Mary. Smith gonna heave it deep, and it's picked, not by Wiggins or any of the seniors, by Anthony Mitchell. The Westlake Hornets are national champions. Now nearing the red zone, Tim Beck is in the backfield, and it is an option. Steven Westwood keeps it. Westwood runs past the defender, and he's gone in open space. 23-yard score for Steven Westwood. Steven Westwood is on for the kneel down, and for the second straight season, the national championship has been won by your Westlake Hornets.
And that brings us to Season 12. Westlake was going for the three-peat against Heisman Trophy winner Billy Joseph and the Fresno State Bulldogs. It looked like Westlake had this game won until they didn't.
Goal from the 9. If Fresno State does not get it, then their chances are pretty much done. Joseph, end zone, touchdown, Bobby Keenan. Westlake is going for the field goal. Interesting call. It's still going to be a one-score game, even if he does make it, which is why this is kind of risky. Volker Guntz from 55, and it is short. Out for Fresno State. If they turn it over, it's game over. Joseph gonna heave it deep, and it's caught by Reed inside the 10. First and goal. Joseph looking to throw it, and it's a touchdown for Chris Reed. Plot twist. Steven Westwood just got hurt. So now it's down to Wesley Thomas. Third and goal, 7 seconds to play. Thomas is going to be a check down for Troy, who is tackled after a gain of 2 with just 2 seconds to play. So now it's fourth and goal. This is it. If Westlake scores, they win. If they don't score, they lose. It's that simple. Thomas going to look to throw it for Cummings, and he dropped it! John Cummings dropped the ball! And Fresno State has won the game.
Heartbreak, disappointment, despair. Westlake has choked yet another national championship. After not making the big game in Season 13, that brings us to the present. New quarterback, new squad, same goal. Welcome back, everybody, to the Westlake Hornets Team Builder Dynasty here on NCAA Football 14. As today, we had the Season 14 National Championship. Westlake going for title number 3 in what should be a fun one against the number 2 ranked Navy Midshipmen. It's been a tough battle for Westlake to get into this game all season. Headed into the conference championship, they knew they had to win pretty convincingly in order to firm their number 1 spot. Well, they didn't win convincingly, but Navy barely beat Virginia, And number three, Texas lost to Oklahoma State, setting up a pretty easy decision for the committee and who to have play in the national title. Navy is known for their rushing attack, their triple option. We all know military schools love their options, and Navy is no different. Led by potential Heisman runner, quarterback Andy Mason, he is one of the top dual threat quarterbacks in the nation. Navy's a very efficient offense. They don't turn the ball over too often, and their defense is pretty solid as well. Welcome, everybody, to the Fiesta Bowl, but in this case as well, the national title. 12-1, Navy midshipmen taking on the number one ranked 12-1 Westlake Hornets in what should be a very fun game of football. Westlake has made four of the past five national titles, but it feels like a while since the Hornets have been in the big game, specifically since John Cummings dropped a ball against Fresno State. Zebediah Phoenix kicks this one off, and we are underway. The national title game between Navy and Westlake. Jones returns it to around the 25 before being tackled by Nick Lott. Westlake will be starting this game on defense. We know their D, specifically their run D, is very good, but this is their biggest test yet. Third and five, it's a short pass for Brad Bullock, and he only gets four. The freshman, Joe Lilly, with a huge tackle to force a Navy punt. Good start for the defense, and now here's the offense, led by sophomore quarterback Keith Fleming. Fleming on third and six, tries to get it to Carter Westwood, but the pass is incomplete. That was right in his hands, but Westwood drops it. Not a great start to the national title for the star senior receiver. So Navy has it back. Defense is looking good early, as it's going to be an option. Andy Mason has a few blocks, and there goes Mason! 55 yards to the house like a deer in headlights. Touchdown, midshipman, and Navy will strike first. What a run by Andy Mason, one of the best dual threat quarterbacks in college football. Excellent blocking by the left side of the Navy offensive line, and Mason used his athleticism for the rest of that play. So Navy now leads this game 7-0. Not a great start for the Hornets, as there's a first down. Fleming connecting with Carter Westwood for a gain of 16. Obviously, this is Westwood's final game, one of Westlake's most storied receivers. He was outstanding in the Season 11 national title against Tennessee, in which he was a true freshman. Here is an option here for Isaiah Sparks, who jukes a couple defenders, and there goes Isaiah Sparks! Down the field, a 59-yard touchdown run by the junior, and Westlake will tie it up. No defense has been able to stop Isaiah Sparks these past couple of weeks. He's been absolutely incredible as of late, and Westlake will match Navy with another 50-plus yard touchdown run, and this game is tied at 7. Good start for both rushing offenses as the midshipmen get it back. Looks like it's going to be a handoff for the big fullback, Anthony Anderson, who gets 18 yards. Navy's one of the few teams in the nation who still use their fullback quite a lot, and Anderson's one of the key cogs on this offense. Looks like Navy's prepared to run another triple option here, and they will. It's going to be a toss for the sophomore Ben Horton, who gets the first down. Navy really running the ball well. Back in Season 10, when Westlake played Army, the Hornets' defense stopped Army's option offense to perfection. Now, granted, there's a totally new slate of players on this defense, but Westlake knows how to game plan for options. Third and six, Mason is going to be sacked for a loss of two by the senior linebacker Dylan Washington. First sack of the game for either team. A huge play by Washington. And we've seen senior linebackers in the past, like Lewis Kahn and Justin McGee, dominate in national title games. And Dylan Washington's going to try to be the next. Here's a nice play from Isaiah Sparks, getting the first down, gaining 14 yards on the reception. As good as Sparks has been in the run game lately, he's been used a lot more as a receiver as of late as well, and Sparks has been one of the top players in the country this past month. Another nice run there for Sparks. He has 69 yards on the game now on the ground. Nice. I know Westlake probably does not want to give him the ball now for keeping that meme afloat, but he's Isaiah Sparks. He's going to need to touch the rock again. Fleming was under pressure there. He does connect with Carter Westwood for a gain of 19 yards and a first down. Hornets moving the ball down the field nicely as it's Cassius Troy with a gain of 13 there on 2nd and 9. Westlake getting very close to the end zone as they try to take the lead before the end of this quarter. 2nd and 2. Fleming under pressure connects with Carter Westwood for the touchdown, and the Westlake Hornets will gain the lead for the first time today. Back-to-back, nice drives from the offense. That one was very efficient, running and passing. Westlake leads 14-7 with a little bit under a minute to go in the first quarter. Navy has it, 2nd and 5. It's another option for Bullock. He just demolishes Bob Adams off of them. What a first down run by Brad Bullock, the top running back on this Navy squad. That'll do it for the first quarter. Defense has started off hot, but it looks like we might have ourselves a high-scoring game. 14-7, Westlake leads. Navy does have the ball at the moment, as on first down, it's a pitch for Brad Bullock. He gets the first down inside the red zone for a gain of around 16 yards. Hot start today for Brad Bullock, along with the rest of this Navy rushing attack. This time, it's a toss for Ben Horton, and he will lose a couple. There were about 5 or 6 Westlake defenders in the area. Dylan Washington credited with the tackle. Washington's probably been Westlake's best defender so far today. He's been very impressive in his final collegiate game. 3rd and 3. The pass is somehow caught by Adrian Gillett. Bob Adams thought he had that pass picked off. Would have been his 5th INT of the season. But instead, it's a first down for the midshipmen as they inch closer and closer to the end zone. 2nd and goal. It's a pitch for Brad Bullock. Untouched like weekend homework, and we're tied at 14. Back and forth game thus far. We've got ourselves a very exciting game of football up to this point. And Westlake would get the ball back. Tied at 14. A little bit under 4 minutes left to go in the half. 2nd and 2. Fleming keeps it himself. Is pounded, but not before gaining 8 yards and a first down. Keith Fleming has had a quiet day on the ground, although he has been very efficient throwing the ball. Not a lot of mistakes thus far from Keith Fleming. Handoff for Irving Porter now on first down, and he loses 3. Navy's rushing defense trying to get into a little bit of a groove as it's the superstar linebacker Demetrius Carter who brings him down. 3rd and 7 now for Westlake. A first down would be huge here. Fleming scrambling to the right side, and he will run for a gain of 14 yards, keeping the chains moving. Huge play by Fleming, who continues to have a very, very good first half. 3rd and 1 now. 2 minutes to play until halftime as it's Isaiah Sparks with the first down and more, getting it inside the red zone for a gain of around 8 yards. Sparks just has 3 carries today, but he already has 77 yards and a touchdown. Very impressive in limited carries so far today. 2nd and 7. Back to Sparks. He has a nice block, and Sparks will find the end zone again. 2 touchdowns in the first half today for Isaiah Sparks, and Westlake will regain the lead with a little bit under a minute and a half to go in this first half. What a start to this game for Isaiah Sparks and the offense as a whole. Other than that first drive, the offense has been pretty much flawless today. Navy going to try to drive down the field and tie it before halftime. Nice catch there by Adrian Gillett, his 2nd of the game. Obviously, Navy has not thrown the ball a ton. That's what you would expect, but Navy has to be unpredictable in their play calls. They just can't run triple option all day. 3rd and 9, deep ball, and it's underthrown, broken up by Mac Terry. And Westlake gets the ball back with a little bit under 50 seconds to go, but not great field position. So they probably won't score on this drive unless they can get a few big plays. And hey, that's a start. Isaiah Sparks gets 13 yards. He's now over 100 on the game. Following play, tough throw into the hands of Cassius Troy for a gain of 16 yards. That'll keep the chains moving. Westlake trying to hold on to their 2 timeouts. Now under 30 seconds to go. McBride outruns the defender, and the Hornets are getting very close to field goal range. We know Zebediah Phoenix II is one of the top kickers in college football. As Westlake has 5 seconds with no timeouts, they're going to try to get a quick play to the end zone, and if it doesn't work, kick the field goal. Fleming nearly got sacked. He throws it away in the nick of time. A very heads-up play by Fleming. It will be an intentional grounding, but still a very smart play by Keith Fleming. So that'll send out the field goal unit. This is a long one, a 56-yard attempt for Zebediah Phoenix II, and it's just short. That one looked like it was going to go in, but not quite. Zebediah Phoenix has really been off these past couple of weeks. He only missed 2 kicks in the first 11 games of the year. He's missed 4 in the past 3. That'll do it for half number 1. Westlake leads 21-14 in what has been a very exciting game of football thus far. Get your popcorn now because this second half is going to be a lot of fun. Westlake opens up with the football. They have an opportunity to make this a 2-score game. Second and four, another option. Toss for Isaiah Sparks, who will run for the first down. The Hornets have really ran the ball well today. Obviously, Isaiah Sparks has. Irving Porter, Keith Fleming, and John Cummings have all been pretty solid, too. Second and four, Fleming finds an open man. It's Tegan Moon, his first reception of the game, going for 24 yards as the Westlake Hornets are now in the red zone, and the Hornets are really starting to get some momentum here. First down, following play from around the 18. Keith Fleming has time. It's a short pass for McBride, and he loses three. The Navy defense immediately bringing him down, and it's been a quiet game for Dale McBride. McBride was incredible in the first half of this season. Towards the second half of the year, he's been good, but I wouldn't say as good. Third and five, big play here for the Westlake offense as Keith Fleming has no time to throw it, and he loses seven on the sack. Doug Baker brings him down, so now it's fourth and 12. Westlake gonna go for the routine field goal. This one should be pretty easy for Zebediah Phoenix from around 33, and he misses it! Zebediah Phoenix, wide right, one of the most accurate kickers in college football, and he's 0 for 2 on field goals today. I don't know what has happened these past couple of weeks to Zebediah Phoenix, but he's been off. Westlake lost the Season 6 National Championship due to kicking. Westlake lost the Season 12 National Championship due to kicking, and they could lose this one due to kicking. Good run by Andy Mason as he brings it past the 50. That field goal miss really gives Navy a ton of momentum. Westlake's had back-to-back good drives, but have not been able to score due to poor kicking. Brad Bullock now down the field. He actually fumbled it out of bounds. Mac Terry with the hit, but Bullock gets 22 yards, and the possession will remain with Navy as the midshipman offense is looking pretty good thus far here on this first drive of the second half. Following play, under 3 minutes to go in the third. Mason, it's going to be another pitch here for Johnson, and this is the freshman, Will Johnson, into the end zone for a 27-yard touchdown. What a run. Again, excellent blocking by Navy. Johnson was able to find the holes, and the midshipmen tie it with 2:38 to go in the third. What a game it has been thus far. Westlake has it back as they try to regain the lead. First play of the drive, it's a handoff for Irving Porter. Porter runs past the safety, and there goes Porter down the field. A big gain of 29 yards, and the Westlake Hornets continue to run the ball very well in this football game. Second and inches now from around the 44. Hornets pass midfield. Fleming scrambling. He's going to dump it off short for Carter Westwood, who makes a nice play after the catch, gaining around 20, bringing it inside the 25. Other than that drop on the opening possession, Carter Westwood has had probably his best game of the year thus far. Second and one, Fleming back to Westwood inside the five, and the Hornets with another very good drive. They are inching so close to this end zone, and Westlake's offense just continues to be incredible today. Second and goal, handoff for Isaiah Sparks. That's the hat trick. Three scores today for Isaiah Sparks. And Westlake regains the lead with just 7 seconds to go here in quarter number three. What a run and what a game for Isaiah Sparks. He has just been absolutely on fire these past 4 or 5 games. That'll do it for quarter number three. But Westlake Hornets are one quarter away from winning their third national title. But this one is far from over. Westlake has choked bigger leads than this, and Navy is still right in this game. Second and seven, it's a toss for Ben Horton. He gets the first down before getting laid out by Bob Adams. Still a nice gain of 12 by Horton, and Navy has just really ran the ball well today. Westlake's rushing defense has been incredible this year, but they have been far from incredible today. Second and six, it's the fullback Anderson, gaining 13 before being wrapped up by the senior safety, Kevin Blanchard. Navy is moving the ball down the field very nicely as they try to potentially tie this game up. 5.5 to go. Third and three. A huge first down run for Andy Mason. Breaking tackles eventually brought down by the true freshman, Winston Johnson, as Mason now nearing the 100 yards mark on the day. Second and two. Under 5 to play in regulation. Mason stopped for a loss of 3. What a hit by Dylan Washington, who continues to have a very good performance today. His draft stock is certainly going up right now. That hit by Washington was so hard that there's a backup quarterback in the game. It's Randall. Third and five, short throw for Wheeler, and he does not get it. Mac Terry forced another fumble on the play. It once again goes out of bounds. So now it's 4th and 1. The biggest play of the game thus far with a backup quarterback in. It's the senior, Eric Randall, who's never gotten a chance to shine until now. Randall with the 1st and more into the end zone for a touchdown. What a run by Eric Randall, and we are tied at 28 with 4 and change to go. If Andy Mason's day is indeed done, this senior, who's never really gotten a shot at quarterback for Navy, will have to lead his team to a national title. 28-28, 4 minutes to go. Keith Fleming and Westlake going to try to drive down the field and take the lead, as that pass should have been intercepted, but instead it's a gain of 20. Very lucky there for Keith Fleming, and some icing on top as it's a nice run from Troy. I don't know if you guys just saw the bottom, but Andy Mason has suffered a mild concussion. His day and his college career are finished. So that means it'll be Eric Randall at quarterback for the rest of this one for Navy. 2nd and 4, Fleming scrambling to the left side, going to try to run for a 1st down, and he does. Fleming inside the 30, and Westlake is in field goal range. But with how shaky Zebediah Phoenix has been as of late, you never really can trust his leg at this moment. 3.5 minutes to go, 1st down. Fleming scrambling to the right now. He has an open man. It's Dale McBride who makes a tough one-handed grab for a gain of 12, and the Hornets are now in the red zone as they are inching very close to this end zone, trying to get the lead back. 1st down, handoff for Sparks. He breaks a tackle, and he fumbles the football, and it's picked up by Navy. Are you kidding? Baker recovers down the field. Miller and Moon are chasing after him, but Navy will now get the ball inside the red zone. A costly fumble by Isaiah Sparks, who's been so, so good today. And Navy has an opportunity to take the lead, but this play is getting reviewed. And as you can see, it's very close, but right here, the right knee is down and Isaiah Sparks still has possession. The call would be reversed. A massive break for Westlake. They will retain the football. The Hornets are very, very lucky, but I will say that's the right call. 2nd and 13 now. It's a handoff for the senior, John Cummings. Cummings breaks away into open space for a touchdown. John Cummings could be the hero. He choked as a sophomore in season 12, dropping the game-winning pass. And now as a senior, he has an opportunity to get the go-ahead touchdown, giving Westlake the lead with 2:44 to go. A huge run for Cummings. And now Navy's going to have to drive down the field with a backup quarterback. What can Randall do? As it's a handoff for Anderson, and the ball's out, and it's picked up by Gardner. Westlake forces a fumble, and I don't think this one's going to be reviewed. The senior, Kez October, with the play of his career, ripping the ball out of Anderson's hands, and another senior, Nick Gardner, picks it up. The play would not be reviewed, and Westlake is all of a sudden in the driver's seat. A 1st down could end it. Hornets trying to chew some clock, as on 1st down, it's a gain of 2. For Irving Porter, Navy calls their 1st timeout. Their fullback, Anderson, who forced the costly fumble, is a little bit banged up. Navy's gotten hammered by injuries tonight. Obviously, they lost their quarterback earlier. It's on 2nd and 8. John Cummings gets a few. Navy calls timeout number 2. And this is it. A 1st down ends it. 3rd and 6. Fleming and Cummings in the backfield as John Cummings gets the handoff. And he's trying to fight for the 1st down, but he does not get it. Navy with the play, and now the field goal unit's going to come on. I'm getting bad flashbacks of some previous choked field goals. Matt Fellows in season 6, if that kick goes in, Westlake would have won the game. How about season 12, Volker Gantz? If this kick goes in, Westlake would have won the game, but it didn't. And now Zebediah Phoenix is in a similar position as those guys. 4th and 3 for the lead, and it will curve in, but barely. Zebediah Phoenix is so lucky that kick went in. Otherwise, he would have been crucified by every Westlake fan. Phoenix has had a rough game. That was a very ugly kick. But Westlake now leads this game by 2 possessions. And Navy's going to need a miracle. But again, Westlake's choked worst in the past. Randall sacked for a loss of 2. Nick Gardner brings him down. A big 4th quarter for the senior Gardner, who recovered the fumble and now gets a sack. Navy, remember, does not have any timeouts. 3rd and 12. Randall Gonna look to throw it, and it's caught by McCray for the first down, and the midshipman will keep the game alive. 15 yards for McCray following play. Randall, over to Wright this time, inside the 35. It's a gain of 25 for John Wright. Still over a minute to go. Navy knows they have to score here, get an onside kick, and score again. Randall on first down, off balance throw. It's caught by Wheeler, who gets three. Clock is running. Third and three now, 43 to go. Midshipmen need a first down, and if they don't get a first, they're probably going to kick a field goal. Randall to the end zone. It's intercepted. That'll do it. Kevin Blanchard, the senior, with the INT, and I think it's fair to say this game is adjourned. Blanchard, who's dropped a number of interceptions in his career, catches the walk-off here in the national title game. And that is how this one will come to a close. Westlake in victory formation. The sophomore, Keith Fleming, for the kneel down. And there you go, folks. National title number three for the Westlake Hornets as the clock continuing to run. Hornets, no need to run another play as the clock will finally hit triple zeros. And there you go. It took two seasons for Westlake to avenge their loss to Fresno State. But congratulations to the Westlake Hornets as they have won the national championship game. This was certainly a very exciting game, and I will say, I think this is the first time that Westlake really did not have control throughout the entire game. In the first four national titles, the Hornets were in the driver's seat through three quarters. Obviously, they choked two of them at the end, but this one was back and forth for the most part. Keith Fleming, 21 of 25, 237 and a touchdown. One of the most efficient games of his career. Not a lot of big plays from Keith Fleming, but he did not make any mistakes, and he had an excellent performance. Isaiah Sparks, 10 carries, 125 yards, and 3 touchdowns. He had that big run to start things off, and he was really good afterwards. The rushing offense as a whole was phenomenal. 64 yards for Porter, 52 for Fleming, 45 in the go-ahead touchdown for senior John Cummings, making up for his drop in season 12. Who is your game MVP? Is it Keith Fleming? Is it Isaiah Sparks? Is it someone on defense? Dylan Washington was phenomenal, but I think this award has to go either to Fleming or Sparks. I don't think you could really argue with either one. I don't think there's a clear choice. If I had to pick, I would probably say Fleming. But Isaiah Sparks ran for 3 touchdowns. He was incredible. Also got to give a shout out to Carter Westwood. He was very good in his final college football game. He's going to make somebody picking in the top 5. Very excited to have him on their team. We forced 2 turnovers. Mac Terry as well forced 2 fumbles that were not recovered. But that Kez October play late in the fourth quarter, that play is what won us the game. I don't really want to look at the kicking stats, but we will anyway. Zebediah Phoenix, 1 for 3. He has not been on his A game towards the end of the year, but he made the kick that he needed to down the stretch. Navy certainly gave it their all. Kind of odd that Eric Randall threw more passes than Mason, even though Randall was only in the game for like 2 drives. But Navy really just did not get the passing game going. Our coverage was very good. Obviously, they ran the ball well with a number of different players. No clear star running it for Navy, but they had a bunch of guys who really ran it well. So what does this mean for the future of the series? I know a lot of people have wondered when the Westlake dynasty will come to a close, and it's something that's kind of weighted on my mind for a while. In the channel update video that I uploaded around a month ago, I mentioned that Westlake would end sometime in 2021, although I was very unclear when the series would officially end. First off, we do add another trophy, as you can see there, but back to the point. So I've been really thinking about this probably for close to a year now, when I'm going to end the series. And last summer, I really thought of a good time to end it. And the number that really stuck into my mind was 16 seasons. And now I can officially tell you guys that the Westlake Dynasty will run 16 years. So that means that we have 2 more seasons left in the series. For season 15, we will move divisions. So we will go from the Pac-12 South to the Pac-12 North. And in season 16, we will go to the Independence Conference for the final year. After season 16, I plan on doing a 5-year simulation to see what happens to all of these recruiting classes. We're going to move back into the Pac-12, I think. And I'm going to have 5 more episodes. 1 for seasons 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21. And then that will do it officially for this Westlake dynasty. So we're going to play 16 seasons and we're going to go through 21 seasons total. Once Westlake ends, I do plan on doing another dynasty on NCAA 14. I don't think it'll be right when Westlake ends. I'm probably going to need a few weeks hiatus just because I've been playing this game so much for the past 3 years, and it's been uploaded so much the past 3 years that I'm going to need like a 2 or 3 week break, so you're going to have to bear with me there. But I will be starting a new dynasty. I don't know if it's going to be a team builder or a death penalty or a custom coordinator or whatever. We're gonna talk about that in a couple months, what kind of dynasty I do after this one. I plan on buying a PlayStation 3 so I can download the College Football Revamp mod. And I think that the new series will hopefully be on the Revamp mod, which is something that I am pretty excited about. Obviously, this series will not be on the mod. I think if I do download the Revamp mod for the Xbox, I think, first of all, it's super complicated. And I don't even know if this would save. And obviously, we don't want this file to get corrupted. So I'm not going to try to download the mod. But I think for the next Dynasty, that's probably what I'm going to do. So that will end today's episode. I hope you guys enjoyed another national title. The offseason will premiere sometime this week. Hope you guys are excited. I'm out. Peace.